Why the sodium channel is permeable to sodium, but not chloride. And why the potassium channel is permeable to potassium, but not to sodium. In this video, we will discuss the selective permeability of protein channels. A brief answer is that the ion selectivity results from characteristic features of the inside surface of the channel that makes the pore. These properties are diameter and shape of the pore, and electrical charges and chemical bonds along the inside surface. These characteristics of the channel determine which ion can pass through and which cannot. Now, before we see an example of any channel, you need to understand how a dissolved ion interacts with water molecules. So let's see that very quickly. This is a water molecule. In water molecule, we have one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms. The electron pair in between the oxygen and hydrogen is pulled more strongly by oxygen. So it lies more close to the oxygen than hydrogen. This gives the oxygen a partial negative charge and hydrogen atoms a partial positive charge. Because of this, an oxygen atom of one water molecule and a hydrogen atom of another are attracted to each other. This bond is called a hydrogen bond. Multiple such bonds can be seen around one water molecule. Now, this bond is not so strong. In the liquid state of water, the water molecules are continuously in random motion. As they move, such hydrogen bonds keep forming and breaking with nearby water molecules. Now let's say we have dissolved a positively charged ion in the water. Here also, the negative charge on the oxygen atom of water gets attracted to this positive charge. Thus, a charged ion does not exist totally free. Rather, it's bound to water molecules surrounding it. And remember, these bonds also keep shifting from one water molecule to another as they all keep moving in a liquid state. If all this is clear to you, we can now see why the sodium channels are highly selective for sodium ions only. This is a sodium channel. Its inner surface is lined with negatively charged amino acids. In the surrounding fluid, we have a sodium ion with water molecules weakly bound to it. During its random movement, let's say it comes close to this channel at some point in time. Now, the negative charge on the inside of the channel pulls the positively charged sodium ion into the channel. So its bonds with water molecules break, and free sodium ion enters the channel. From here, it can cross the channel. On the other side, it again binds with the water molecules located over there. Thus, the sodium channel allows the passage of sodium. If a negatively charged ion, for example chloride, comes close to it, it's simply repelled by the negative charge of the channel. So negatively charged ions cannot cross the sodium channel. But what about other positively charged ions, like potassium and calcium? Well, I guess they are simply too large to fit into the channel. So they also cannot pass through the sodium channel. So this is why sodium channels are highly selective for the passage of sodium ions. Now, if you are intelligent, you might ask, if sodium ions are smaller than potassium, why don't they also diffuse through the potassium channel? Let me give you the answer. Near the outer side of the potassium channel, the pore region has carbonyl oxygens. Let's say a potassium ion, with all its surrounding water molecules, has come close to it. We earlier saw that hydrogen bonds keep shifting from molecule to molecule as the ions move freely in the liquid state of water. Similarly, here also, the bonding of potassium ion can shift from water molecule to carbonyl oxygen. The key point here is the distance between the potassium ion and the carbonyl oxygen. Because the potassium ion is large, it reaches the carbonyl oxygen very closely. This distance is almost equal to its distance from the oxygen atom of a water molecule. So it's very easy for the bonds to shift from water to the carbonyl oxygen. and as it happens, the surrounding water leaves the potassium ion. Now this plain potassium ion can enter, and therefore, cross the channel. Now what if a sodium ion comes nearby? The sodium ion is smaller in size. So relative to its distance from oxygen of water, its distance from carbonyl oxygen of channel is very long. So the sodium ion cannot interact with the carbonyl oxygen. And therefore, it cannot get rid of the water molecules bound to it. Such an ion with water molecules bound to it cannot fit into the channel, and therefore cannot cross it. Because of these properties of the potassium channel, the potassium channel is 1,000 times more permeable to potassium than sodium, even though sodium is a smaller ion. So this is all about the selective permeability of channels. Please note that I have explained concepts in a simplified and schematic way. Selectivity to other ions, like calcium, chloride, etc., are also determined by such intricacies of channel structure only. But I don't think we need to go into any further detail for each and every channel. Having this much idea is enough to know why different channels are more selective to certain ions only. In summary, the selectivity of a channel is determined by the diameter and shape of the pore and electrical charges and chemical bonds along the inside surface. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire physiology animation video library over there. To support my free content creation, leave a nice comment and share the video with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.